Today we are counting down the top 5 bad ideas you can have while keeping tarantulas. So stick around. Welcome to the Tarantula Collective. My name is Richard, and today we're counting down the top 5 bad ideas that I've had or other people have when it comes to keeping tarantulas. Now, I get messages, emails, comments all the time from people asking questions, things that seem like a very good idea in theory, but in practice turns out to be a horrible idea. So instead of responding to these dozens and dozens of questions individually, I figured I'd make a video and get them all taken care of at once. Now, if you've done this yourself, I'm not judging you. Don't feel bad. A lot of people make these mistakes. I've even had some of these ideas and had to learn the hard way that they're not as good of a plan as I thought they were to begin with. So counting down, starting with number 5, a really bad idea is buying a tarantula as a gift or as a prop. Tarantulas are living creatures, and they need to be shown that respect. Some can live as long as 30 years. So it's not a good idea to buy one as a gift for someone that isn't expecting it, doesn't have all of the necessary enclosures and substrate and everything you need to house a tarantula properly, but also the time commitment involved. You don't want to buy a tarantula for someone as a present who wasn't expecting it and lock them into having a pet for 10 to 30 years. If you really want to get someone a tarantula as a pet, the best thing to do is to buy them a gift certificate to their favorite tarantula dealer. That way they can choose the species they're getting, as well as choose the time that it arrives at their door. It also gives them the opportunity to do a lot of research and know exactly how to take care of that specific species. And not just buying it as a gift, I've seen a lot of people that are buying tarantulas as a prop. They've got a photo shoot or they're making a video and they want to have a tarantula in there. So they buy this tarantula with the intention of just using it for a photo shoot, possibly not taking into consideration that these things can live for decades. And most animal shelters won't accept tarantulas. And when they're done, they just don't know what to do with it. They're trying to give it away or resell it online. I even saw a few people suggest they were just gonna release it out into the desert, not taking into consideration what species it is or where it even came from. So if you're gonna buy a tarantula, make sure you're willing to commit to keeping this species as a pet for as long as it's alive, which for some New World terrestrial species can be 20 or 30 years. Now, the number 4 bad idea when keeping tarantulas is being a helicopter parent or a helicopter keeper. And what I mean by that is being a keeper that's constantly messing with your tarantula, whether you're rearranging its enclosure or rehousing it way too often, changing out the substrate, or just bothering it every single day. The more you bother your tarantula, the longer it's gonna take for it to settle in and be comfortable in its enclosure. Constantly moving things around in its enclosure, whether it's just reorganizing or redecorating, moving a hide from one side to the other, constantly adding plants and new little decorations, or taking it out of its enclosure to handle it, changing its substrate unnecessarily, doing a needless rehouse, like you got a brand new enclosure and for no reason you're gonna move it, or just digging it out of its burrow to make sure it's alive. All of these things can cause your tarantula a lot of unneeded stress. For one, tarantulas don't really enjoy being handled. They don't like interacting with humans. So removing it from its enclosure just to handle or show off to your friends can cause some stress and make it really difficult for the tarantula to relax in its own enclosure. Now, I'm not saying never handle your tarantulas. I'm just saying it's not something you should be doing every day or even every week. And the only time I change the substrate in my enclosure is if there's a huge mold outbreak or something has gone terribly wrong that I can't remedy just by drying out the enclosure. I've seen some people at the first sign of a mold outbreak completely remove all the substrate, wash everything down, and rebuild the enclosure from scratch, when really all they needed to do was cut back on the amount of moisture in that enclosure for a few weeks. Or people have gotten really freaked out by wood mites and completely sanitized an enclosure and rebuilt it from the bottom up, when really all they needed to do was just lower the moisture level in the enclosure. Now, I have a whole video I'll link at the end of this video about mites and what to do if you do have a mite infestation. But a long story short, just leave your tarantulas alone. Don't bother them unless you really need to, because the less stressed they are, the more relaxed they are in the enclosure, the more of an opportunity you will have to see them out in the open. So don't be a helicopter keeper. Number 3, and this is a big one, and that is using one single source for all of your information. I say this a lot in my videos, but don't just take my word for it. Do your own research. Use the videos that I post on my channel or the information on my website or Instagram or Facebook group or anywhere as just one source, a starting point for learning about your tarantula. All I'm sharing is my experience, my opinions, the things that I've learned. But there's a whole lot of different opinions, people with different experiences, and different methods and philosophies altogether about keeping tarantulas. I find the best thing, what works for me, is to get my information from as many sources as possible. Use what applies. You have to remember that people are living in different countries and different climates, different environments, different types of houses. So how I take care of my tarantulas that I keep in the basement of my house in the foothills of the Appalachian Mountains may be slightly different from someone keeping them in an attic that lives in the deserts of Arizona, or how someone in the Philippines or in Scotland or, you know, anywhere in the world. Temperatures, humidity, all these things are going to be slightly different and will require some adjustments on how you keep your tarantula in captivity. So by all means, watch as many of my videos as possible. It definitely helps out, but don't use me as your sole source of information any more than you would use any other channel or resource. The more information that you can gather on your species and how to take care of them, the wider that base of knowledge is going to be. And just like a pyramid, the wider the base, the taller the point, which would be your success as a keeper. So get as many sources, as much information as you can. Reach out to people on arachnoboards or on these tarantula Facebook groups and ask questions. Get their experience and opinions. And take all that information, figure out what works best for you and your tarantula, and be the best possible keeper that you can. Now, the number two bad idea is one that I've been guilty of myself, and that is rescuing a tarantula from a pet store. We've all gone to Petco or PetSmart or whatever the chain pet store is in your area and seen that maybe they have one or two tarantula species available for sale. And typically the husbandry is terrible. They're not keeping them the way that they should be kept. And if you're anything like me, your first instinct is I'm gonna buy that tarantula, take it home, set it up in a proper enclosure, and give it the best life possible, which is a very empathetic thing to do and completely understandable. But these chain pet stores are first and foremost a business. And if you're buying the tarantula, it's gonna show up in their sales records as something that is a hot item. They need to restock. So the more tarantulas you buy to save from the pet store, the more they're gonna stock. And it's just gonna perpetuate this cycle. Every time you go in there, they'll have a new tarantula still kept pretty poorly. And you'll buy that tarantula and go back next week, they'll have another one. And a lot of times these chain pet stores don't really know the species of the tarantula or if it's male or female. And a lot of times they're overpriced. So a better idea is to support your local breeders and dealers. Almost every state in the country, there is someone breeding and selling tarantulas. There are a lot of small businesses online that sell tarantulas that know a whole lot about the species that they're breeding and selling, and can give you some very good advice, and you know that they're going to be healthy, happy tarantulas at a fair price. So support your local bug dealers, support the hobby. And the number one bad idea when keeping tarantulas, and this is a question or a comment that I get more than any of them out there, and that is putting a spiderling in an adult enclosure. I understand why a lot of people think this is a brilliant idea, because you won't have to rehouse a tarantula ever. You see this a lot more with people that are getting their first old world tarantula. They're nervous about rehousing their OBT or postlitheria, so they have their tiny sling around an inch and want to just go ahead and house it in the adult enclosure. In theory, brilliant idea, makes a lot of sense. In practice, no, not a good idea at all. There are a lot of reasons, but the most important reason is that adult enclosures are built for adult tarantulas or adult reptiles. A spiderling could very easily squeeze out of the gap in the door or even the vent holes in a lot of those enclosures. Tarantulas are escape artists. They can be tricky. They may look larger than the hole, but if they can fit that tiny carapace through the gap in the door or the vent hole, they could squeeze their entire body out and be gone, and you'll never know where they went. Another issue is that you can lose a tarantula just inside the enclosure. One of the first spiderlings I ever got was a Brachypelma homori. I didn't realize how small it was gonna be. It had a 5-gallon aquarium set up perfectly for a tarantula. Unboxed it, realized it was a tiny sling, probably about a half an inch. And I knew right away I couldn't keep it in this enclosure because it was way too big. It could just stroll right out of the vent hole in the top. So I grabbed a smaller sling enclosure and set it inside of the large enclosure to do the rehousing. And the tarantula ran out of the spiderling enclosure and I lost it in the substrate of the large enclosure, which was a bad idea. I should have just done it on the tape. But I was new and I felt like it was the safest way. But that sling got away fast and burrowed into the substrate before I could even realize exactly where it went. Luckily, I was able to find it and move it into its spiderling enclosure. But if I was planning on keeping it in that enclosure, I don't know if I would have ever known where it was. And it's not just a risk of you not knowing where your tarantula is. It's also a lot more difficult for them to find their prey. Tarantulas don't hunt. They're not stalking down prey like a tiger in the jungle. They're opportunistic feeders. So they essentially wait for prey like a cricket or a mealworm or whatever it is you're feeding your tarantula to cross its path. They don't move very far outside of the area of their burrow. So one risk that you run keeping a spiderling in an adult enclosure is that the prey will be on one side of the enclosure, the sling will be on the other, they'll never cross paths, and your tarantula just won't have any food. Same thing with water. It can be dangerous to have that much space in an enclosure. You want to make sure that your tarantula has easy access to both its food and its water. And that's just not something that can happen if you have it in a huge enclosure. And the base of this idea really stems from the fear of rehousing, which is understandable because that's like the most vulnerable time, both for the keeper and the tarantula. I suggest starting out easy with some slow moving new world terrestrial tarantulas and build up your experience with rehousing. The more rehousings you do, the more confidence that you'll build and the less fearful you'll be of rehousing larger tarantulas or tarantulas with more speed or more potent venom. But if you're using the tried and true methods of rehousing tarantulas that I've posted on my channel and many other tarantula keepers have posted on their YouTube channels, you're not going to have any problems or very few problems when it comes to rehousing your tarantula. So just do a lot of research, figure out the best method for you, and don't be scared of rehousing your species. And definitely don't put your spiderlings in adult enclosures. Now, if you want some information on more mistakes to avoid while keeping tarantulas, I will link a playlist to those videos right here. As always, I appreciate you watching. Subscribe if you want to see more. Hit that like button if you like tarantulas, and I will see you next Tuesday.